23rd of August in the year 1566, Beeldenstorm, as we call it, is called Icon of Fury. The moment where people stood up against Catholic hierarchy.
People enter the church and basically destroy all kinds of ornaments, images,
sculptures, altar pieces. It was absolutely a revolution because after the Icon of Fury, this city turned into a Protestant city. An enormous change of the power in the city. My name is Jacqueline Grandjean. I'm the director of Oude Kerk. This is the oldest building and the oldest monument of Amsterdam, but it's also one of the newest art institutions. Working here, it's not only working with the building, with the history, with the heritage, especially working with the people. People from the church community, people from the neighborhood.
My name is Aimé Sitolema and I'm a visual artist. The idea is to make a work specifically for this location. I wanted to be in dialogue with the space, and I wanted the work to be in dialogue with the space.
Working with Aimé was wonderful. Aimé is based in Amsterdam. She could do research, she could come over. We had long conversations on the Beeldenstorm, the Icon of Fury.
Here's where we meet, is actually a proposal. Proposing a space where eventually different visions can meet. Contemporary art can also invite people to reflect and think about the use of spaces. We can use history also to think about the future. Contemporary art is, in a way, a form of dealing with heritage. There is a process of transformation going on in this 4 months of the exhibition. Each of the bassins has actually a different image from the ceiling, from the wall painting. We were on the floor and Evelyn Renaud was the photographer. She just had like this huge tele lens basically, so we could get like this close to the images. The photographs were floating and then after 2-3 weeks, the paper sort of sucks the water and then goes down and now it's slowly falling apart. Paper has a memory. If a paper has been torn, when you put that paper in water, it will remember the shape it had before. So this is a whole process that has to do with transformation, which of course is also interesting in relation to the topics I'm trying to address that also have to do with bigger transformations within society.
I see the change in the paper, and I think this is also crucial and elemental to the history of our species, the history of our planet. We hardly see the change when you look at it from day to day, but if you take a bigger distance, and that's what MA does, you can see the changes.
There used to be this tapestry hanging, and they were destroyed not immediately during the iconoclastic fury, but apparently some years after. I usually work with photography and paper and sculpture. For me, it was a huge discovery. Yeah, I loved it. I was dreaming with textile after working there the whole day. We are at a moment in which many aspects of history are being reviewed. Keeping heritage alive is not only the constant restorations, but there is another aspect of it which has to do with the present. This sort of transformation is what brings also resistance.
We are slow curators here. This is what we do in Oude Kerk, because you need a lot of time to work with artists. People run from one exhibition to the other. Artists are asked to deliver very, very quick, and here you need the time. I always ask the artist to leave behind what he or she has been working on so far, forget what's in the studio, and come here with fresh eyes and discover the place, and that takes time. That's why we call it slow curating.